There are close to 400 different tests available for the GeneSeq Q16, and they're all incredibly easy to use. The protocol is virtually identical for all the different tests. Let's start with a look at the software that drives the Q16. It's incredibly simple to use. There are two main test types that you can perform with the Q16. Either a speciation test. This will tell you what percentage of your sample is derived from a particular species. For example, what percentage of your beef burger is actually horse. Or you can carry out a detection test. This will tell you if your target of interest is present, and if so, how much of it there is. This can be used for detecting bacteria, viruses, fungi, parasites, allergens, and more. On this occasion, we're going to carry out a detection test for Listeria. You can name your experiment here and add notes here if you like. Here is where you define how many samples you're testing. In this case, we're going to keep things as simple as possible and test just one sample. In this panel, you can define how many different tests you're doing. For example, you may want to test for Listeria and Salmonella at the same time. But again, let's keep things simple, and for now, just have the one target. Again, just adjust the label here. Now it's time to open your GeneSeq Easy Kit. The first step is to make up your reaction mix. It's really easy. Add a small volume of the resuspension buffer to the OASIG MasterMix vial. Then transfer all of this into the tube labelled primers and probes. Give the tube a really good shake and leave it to stand for 5 minutes. This reaction mix is now ready to use. So to set up a test, simply combine a small volume of this reaction mix with a small volume of your DNA sample. Close the lid and everything's ready. Each time you perform a test, you'll need to perform a positive and a negative control reaction too. This process is exactly the same, but instead of a DNA sample, you use water for the negative control. And positive control template for the positive control. Now place those tubes into the correct positions in the Q16, as defined by the software. Close the lid and click the start button. If you have more than one Q16 connected, you can select which one you're using here. Or if you're not connected directly and want to run the Q16 from a USB stick, you can select that option here too. But we're using this instrument, so away we go.
Analysis starting.